bitch. Send him to the bench, I done lost all respect. I'm gone down, race it. Don't hit too low, no, I need my leg. Coach, please sit him, young dog, can't catch. Send him to the bench, I done lost all respect. I'm gone.
The shores of Lake Erie, but we have football at First Energy Stadium in Cleveland, Ohio. The folks here in Cleveland, even though all the down years, have never stopped supporting their hometown guys, and we got evidence of that a moment ago as the Browns made their entrance. They are ready to do better with the Detroit Lions. The NFL season has hit high gear, and off we go in Week 11 on EA Sports. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Carry now for the BYU man. It's Jamal Williams. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly. And that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The second down attempt there, knocked down as it leaves the quarterback's hand, and it's incomplete.
Gotta give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and give some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arms down.
An early tough test on the opening drive. This is third and eight. Here's Goff. That's caught by the big tight end, O.J. Howard. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw. And they hooked up there for a first down.
Here's a run on first down that doesn't accomplish anything. In fact, he's going to be tackled behind the line for a loss of one. On second and 11 now. Goff, throw right side, caught by O.J. Howard. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Stopped at the 34-yard line. The they may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
3 yards the gain there, second down.
Now, this defense for the Lions, they were excellent a week ago in the win over Pittsburgh.
Yeah, they only allowed 13 points, and you could poll all 32 coaches, and I guarantee you they'd say, we'll take that every single week. But let me think about that for a second. Maybe there'd be one contrarian that would say, give me 10.
A first carry now for Nick Chubb. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. 13 yards to pick up there. Good for a Cleveland first.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
A run for Nick Chubb. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
Well, this defense for the Lions, they were excellent a week ago in the win over Pittsburgh.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves them with 3rd and 5.
Now, this defense for the Lions, they were excellent a week ago in the win over Pittsburgh.
But we certainly had a nice conversation with the defensive coordinator, didn't we? And what we heard, I like what we did, but we definitely need more pressure on the quarterback this week.
Throwing, Mayfield. He's got a man, it's his fullback. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. 14 yards, and it's a Cleveland first down.
A nice throw there by Mayfield, a guy who really reemerged as the season and later the playoffs went on last year. What are defenses trying to do against him?
Well, the first thing defenses want to do is use his emotion against him because he's such a passionate player that sometimes he comes up really hyped up and the ball might sail a little bit early. But as the game settles in, the next part is make sure you chip away at his timing, put the pressure on him so maybe his feet don't get quite set, and then he's not able to be as accurate as he normally is.
A good pickup there, 22. First and goal, a chance to convert that early turnover into points. They'll run with Chubb, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, digits with his 10th touchdown of the season, and the Browns have taken the early lead. A good hold in these wet conditions. The point after is up and good, and it's now a 7-0 game. McCann's got it teed up. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. But they're hoping.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Woo! Touchdown, Detroit. A big play there. His 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Lions are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
And CD, we have seen some great runs the last few times we've been together, but I think we could at least put this one in our top 5. That was a determined gallop there.
Yeah, and this is one of the best runs you'll see. A lot of times on these long touchdowns, you'll say he gets into the end zone untouched, but not here. He fought his way through contact, and it barely even registered, and he just continued down the field all the way to the end zone.
A fairly short kick from the 14. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Cleveland offense ready to go.
And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm willing to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn it into a play action, and throw one deep.
On second and nine, Mayfield.
He's going to flip one out here to his running back.
And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming. Here's Mayfield. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
And this is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown, that's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand, and forcing a three and out, and giving the ball back to their offense.
On fourth down, here's Jamie Gillen on to punt. Back deep, Khalif Raymond.
Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. And this will be down just on the other side of midfield.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time.
That's
true. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. To throw is gone. A slant to Jones.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
Out of the pistol, here's Williams.
And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. These two teams all tied after one. From the 35 on second down, Goff.
And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose.
So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down.
Now whistles and a flag down. Looked like one of the Lions linemen might have moved.
So the false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now, third and long.
From the gun, here's Goff.
And that is incomplete.
How about this defense that came up with a couple big plays in this sequence, and none better than the one right there, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
The NFC's Pro Bowl punter a year ago, Jack Fox, on to punt for the Lions.
As he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. 31 yards on the punt there. And the Browns will take over with a first and 10 deep in their own territory.
Yeah.
The Browns drive about to get started. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well.
Go to
something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Second and 10. Mayfield down. And oh, he coughs up the football near his own goal line. And into the end zone. A scoop and score on the fumble return for the Detroit touchdown. So the big fella gets on the scoreboard with a return for a touchdown. Good thing he didn't have to go too far, though.
You know the trainers were very happy about that. Imagine having to go get him in the end zone, escort him to the bench, and give him the oxygen. They were loving the fact that he got in without having to run very far.
Extra point was hooking, but he does make it through. And that makes the score 14-7. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. Here's Chris Claybrooks to return. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Cleveland offense ready to go, and they'll be looking to start fresh. Just a moment ago, they were backed up, coughed up the football, and then saw it go the other way for 6 points.
I just wonder, partner, sometimes they put such an emphasis on things, and you know in that situation, as they ran out there, they were told, take care of the football, don't cough it up. And sometimes it's the last thing you hear, and that's exactly what you do.
Second and five now, Mayfield. Dancing to his left. And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. Afadi Adenabo able to run him down for a loss of a yard. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. To throw, Mayfield. Looking deep downfield. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. And he'll return this ball across midfield to the 47-yard line. It's almost like you can see the look of frustration on his face. Four interceptions last week. We talked about it all week. What did he do wrong? And another one here in the first half.
And you can understand the frustration. You actually feel his pain a little bit. But the worst thing he can do is what you're seeing right now, showing the other team that he's frustrated. All they're going to do is double their efforts to make him even more frustrated. He's got a gap.
And he's got his man. It's caught for a Lion touchdown. Khalif Raymond. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Lions are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. When you think of guys that are built to be big arm quarterbacks, Jared Goff, he fits that mold and he showed it off right there. Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And it's now 21-7. Claybrooks to return it. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. And that nearly intercepted. It's incomplete. Now, remember, he had a pick earlier, but couldn't reel that one in.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. On third down, Mayfield. He's going to wind up and air it out. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Now give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
The scoreboard tells a story for them, a little bit bleak, and while it's not quite desperation time yet, it's definitely getting close, but the defense reads the scoreboard as well. They're going to back up and make them really earn it.
And here's Gillen on now to punt as he gets this one away. 37 yards on the punt with no return, and the Lions will take over. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him, because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well. And he's been right.
They stay on the ground. This time it's Williams. And he's going to take this across the 50 into Browns territory. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Good yardage there on first down, exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs, keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
Williams going to get it again on second down. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. The offense on third down tonight, just 1 for 3 thus far. They're looking at third and a few inches. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
You can tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Here's Jack Fox now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Three yards is the distance on the punt there, and the offense will come back out deep in their own territory. The Cleveland offense ready to go, and this not an easy situation. You're down early in the elements, you're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness. Maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
And he gets it here to right around the 24 before he's out of bounds. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
On first and 10, Mayfield. He's going to air one out. It got his man complete. And he is able to take this way down into Detroit territory. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards and runs of 15 or more yards.
They went zooming past that number there. Yeah, he's able to push his way forward somehow for a gain of about 2 yards. Second down now. Two of their 3 red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Now, here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
Now Mayfield on third and goal. And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland. Odell Beckham. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Browns get a late score here in the final minute of the first half.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the first half in fine style, putting that one in the end zone.
They did. They didn't leave much time on the clock either. Well done. So with a missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. Khalif Raymond now. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they've got just over 50 seconds to go till halftime, so they can try to put something together if they want. Now a first down throw. Gone. That'll be caught. It's the tight end, Howard. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Now gone. He's got the hookup to Miller. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll make it a second down. From the 50, it's gone. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
Well, there's times when you see these catches that are made, and we just know the guys playing it are really wishing for college rules. Only need that one foot down instead of two. It's awfully difficult on the sideline, isn't it?
Fake the give. Now gone. He sets to fire deep. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted.
Picked by the rookie Greg Newsom.
And the return goes up to his own 17-yard line.
Okay, partner. No surprise to you. I'm going to look at this from the defensive perspective. In the rain, you have to be more cautious trying to cover passing routes. Why? The offense knows where they're going with the football. The receiver knows the route he's going to run. You have to make sure you keep your footing underneath you.
And there's the rookie from Western Michigan, Dwayne Eskridge.
Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
Hey, water alert, water alert.
Mayfield to throw it. And once again, it's Eskridge. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And this throw will be intercepted. Picked off down near the 5.
Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there, you throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
And they'll begin inside their own 10, so field position certainly not in their favor here.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. Tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. So we have reached halftime with the visiting Lions taking the lead to the break. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. And they're down on the scoreboard. Sort of a sloppy first half. And Coach Davis, if you were in the locker room, what would the message have been?
I think I'd have to go with something you don't ordinarily go with in the NFL. That's a little fire and brimstone. You've got to fire these guys up. Make them understand what's going on out there. They were so sloppy in the first half. Too many turnovers. Tighten things up, maybe get in their face a little bit, get in their grill, and then send them back out.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Mayfield. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. Here's Jamie Gillen now as he's on to punt for Cleveland. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. And this one will be touchdown inside the 40-yard line. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on 1st and 10. Back to throw, gone. And this nearly an interception, but it's incomplete. Well, a turnover really would have helped him there, but not to be.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Off play action. Here's Goff. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call. I think you'd agree that looked like the right call from up here.
No doubt about it. What everyone has to understand is that the officials are going to be right on the play each and every time. You may not like the call, but they're usually spot on.
They'll fake the handoff. Now gone. Blitz coming, and down he goes. In for the sack, Myles Garrett. After the sack, it's 2nd and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Another try after the first down sack. Goff. Throw caught by Raymond.
That's a good bounce back play right there after taking a sack on first down. Didn't quite get it to the marker, but now they're in a much better spot for a third and short yardage call. Through the offensive coordinator, you like looking at that section a heck of a lot better than trying to figure out third and long.
And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play. They'll run it with Williams. Williams is going to have the first down and a little more. Touchdown, Detroit! Jamal Williams, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Lions are able to grow their lead.
The CD, I mean, there are touchdown runs, and then there are touchdown runs. And that one certainly fell into the latter category. Now that deserves a couple exclamation points.
And this is a play defensively where you're just looking around and saying, what was that? What just happened? You're looking at your teammates, they're looking at you. And let's face it, your defensive coordinator, he's not going to tip his cap to him. That's not how football works, but he probably should have after that run. That was absolutely sensational.
And he covered a lot of ground on that one, as evidenced by the final total there on Next Gen Stats.
The Cleveland offense ready to go. Here's Nick Chubb as they try to fire up this run game. He's able to force his way through one man, but he can muster only about a yard on the play. Second down. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Now Mayfield. Throw left side. There's Schwartz with it. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there.
What a dimension this man brings to this defense. He had his mind set there that he was going to get in and make that tackle. He really flew to the football.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. Now Mayfield lost the football, and the Lions have recovered. So that one will be accepted. So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10.
Goff a handoff here to Swift. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
But that kind of run on first down, that's a winning type of a run. That just sets things up for them moving forward as they begin the drive.
Second and 6.
On the counter, here's Williams. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22.
76 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
On the ground, this is Williams. And this carry not as productive. He's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Here's second and 10.
Goff now to throw. Out to the left there and complete to Howard. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. They're able to convert with a gain of 4.
I like the look that they just showed there. When you come out in a passing formation, spread things out a little bit, makes it really hard to cover the middle of the field, doesn't it? Because yeah, you've got to go out to the perimeter and cover those guys.
Yep, exactly. Got some good blocking, too. Helped him pick up the first.
They'll try and run. This is Williams. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they are playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
This is caught, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Jared Goff with his third touchdown pass of the afternoon. And the Lions are able to extend their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical, that's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
And a nice return sets them up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly
right. You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Maybe a little frustration starting to creep in. The offensive line hasn't done a great job of protecting him in this game. And there he was, hit again as he threw it.
Yeah, another time on his backside. Probably starting to get a little frustrated.
Got to keep his composure. Can't let the defense know that they're getting to him.
Third and short yardage, Mayfield. And it's hauled in by Austin Hooper.
And he is going to have a Browns first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Normally on third down and short yardage, you're thinking of throwing to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field, and a nice dart picks up the first down and then some.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Here's Mayfield. Got an open man. That's David Njoku, the tight end. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 11 more on that one, and another first down. Mayfield this time gets it off to Chubb. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Mayfield with it once more. Under pressure, and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Mayfield in this Browns offense staring at a third and long now after the sack. Mayfield looks to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to need a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
Yeah, once again, hit as he throws. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete.
Man, I got you. Man, I got you.
Desperation time. Mayfield on fourth down. And he will find his man, Schwartz. That's complete. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. They go play action. Mayfield. Touchdown! Odell Beckham with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Browns have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth. So up comes Mayfield as his guys will go for two. Mayfield going to try to throw for the two. Now Mayfield lost the football, and this is scooped up by the Lions. He's at the 50, 30, 20. Boy, that got pretty close to disaster. Going for two, you cough it up. They almost returned it all the way to the other end for two for themselves.
You think a lecture on ball security is in order here?
Because
and it's not just taking care of it, is what you just talked about. What can result when you don't take care of it? They almost gave up a score.
And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two. Again, it's Williams. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. They'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down.
Brent, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Goff on third down. That'll be caught. It's the tight end, Howard. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now a man who's been busy this afternoon, it's Williams. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
I know the game's not over, but there's got to be a sense of satisfaction right now for the guy carrying the football a bunch today. 99 yards, and he has enough time to go over the century mark.
You got to give it to him again, right?
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. You're not worried about losing yardage here. You're not worried about any of that. You just want to get him to the promised land for every runner, 100 yards or more in a game.
And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 108 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. On first and 10, it's Swift.
And he stopped immediately there. Malik Jackson there to make the stop.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Goff's throw complete here, pulled in by Howard.
And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns' 13-yard line. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And here he'll get it down to the 7. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. And this defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in. And all you're doing when you talk to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score and this game's over.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Jamal Williams. His 10th touchdown of the season, second of the game. And the Lions are closing in on a third straight win as they widen the gap further here in the fourth quarter.
Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And that pushes the lead up to 23. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
And this taken in at the goal line.
And he's going to be out of bounds. Here is the run back. We'll leave him shy of the 20-yard line. At their own 18-yard line. The Cleveland offense ready to go. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that.
I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's
make
get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better
as they continue
to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Throwing, Mayfield. Caught, left side, it's Beckham. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. Nowhere to go downfield, but he's able to get out of bounds and stop the clock here with a first down. Mayfield to throw it. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. He's got a man complete. Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as they'll get it with just a shade under a minute to go in the game. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. To throw on second and 10, Mayfield. He'll let this go for the end zone. And that's going to be caught for a Browns touchdown. Dwayne Eskridge with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Browns get a score closer.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team. But I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film. But this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
They'll try and throw for it. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. Should have been picked. Probably doesn't matter on a two-point conversion, but still, as a former DB, you want to grab that ball when you can, don't you?
You certainly do, and don't say it, because I know you're thinking it. Don't say it.
What am I thinking?
You know what I know what you're thinking. Well, if he'd had hands, he'd be playing on offense, right?
That's true. You've said that before. Fielded just outside the goal line. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They're looking at a third straight win here if they can hold on. And oh, he coughed it up. But I believe the Lion was there to recover it. Yes, they will indeed keep possession. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about. Getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. You're exactly right. A lost opportunity.
On second down, Williams. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college, and how about in the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee, and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time, ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
Looking pretty good on the scoreboard. They're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. They go ahead and snap it. Gone.
And yet again, Goff is intercepted. Picked off by the rookie, Andre Sisco.
And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Browns defense has a touchdown. This game's still fairly well in hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell and just run the football?
I think you have to, but you also have to tell your backs, make sure you're really protecting the football because you're going to run into a stacked defensive front, which is why they were throwing the football before, trying to make sure they didn't get their backs, you know, really beat up in that situation. Now, good luck to them.
Takes it at the 7.
And he's going to be out of bounds here right at the 20-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they've got this one in hand. No timeouts remaining defensively, so this one should just be one kneel and then handshakes. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. It's a gain of 15, and that ought to just about put an end to this one. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Lions, it's a win that might keep them alive in the playoff race as they're back to 500 at 5-5. And now they'll have the short week ahead as they'll host their annual Thanksgiving Day game on Thursday. Meanwhile, for Cleveland, their luck may have run out as they fall to 4-7 now in the year. And they'll be on the road next week for a matchup with the Baltimore Ravens.
Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I ball. Man, like every day.
Venues and ask them if I could be opening act for the rappers that's passing through town. I used to be the one kids in my city was laughing about. I used to envision everything happening now. I used to ride the bus and listen to Kendrick Lamar. He just liked a video that I made back when I started to study his bars. I'd like to think that he probably related to someone that's come so far. To someone that wanted it badly, then when it got it and turned to a star. Overly dedicated, a title that resonated. I want to be recognized. I want to be decorated. Truthfully, back then, I couldn't imagine a life where I never made it. Go ahead and let them hate it. Let them hate it.
I ain't never had no money. I've been out here trying to give me away. Ain't nobody helping. I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I ball. Man, like every day. For all of that, nobody helped me. Said I ball.
Thank you. Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a tutor. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling. Touchdown, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling.
Don't want your bro, it was for show, just so you know.
We just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, money, mo. All this money, I need mo. Don't want your bro, it was for show, just so you know. We just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, money, mo. All this money, I need mo. Give them a show, killing your nose and taking your bro.
And spinning his bands, oh yeah, did it again, oh yeah. Out with his friend, oh yeah, Chanel is the lens.
Okay.
With his friend, finna get lit. I'm everything on they wish list. Which bag should I get? Which color should I pick? Pick. Any, mini, money, mo. All his money, I need mo. You big bro, gotta go. Big bird, giving crow.
A group of baddies coming foe.
Give me money, kiss my toes. Go with your bro, it was for show, just so you know.
We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit.
Show just so you know,
we just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit.
Any, many, miny, mo.
I shall come forth as pure gold. Have you been tried in the fire? Have you been tried in the fire? Well, tell me, did you come through as pure gold?
You kick it like the benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. I went and got my digits up. Your favorite, bruh. You don't want no trouble, cuz the 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip up in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The mind to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red doggies caught me slipping with the willing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend on me. Chalked it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a, but then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart he find forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was just business for me. When I got on, I paid him back and told him it was ugly. I'd rather ask forgiveness like 100 times than be asking for permission in a beggar's line. Cause of who I be and check out how I tend to mine. I got a partner who don't eat no poke at dinner time. But let you act like you gon' ever hurt or injure mine. He have your woman, and that's my dinner time. I keep my eyes on glory till the devil get behind. Now bear in mind the devil made me offers I decline. We not aligned, not combined, I am not confined to any wicked system that these demons have designed. They frame a mind and have you salty as a bacon rind. I'm trying to mastermind how to help out humankind. I'm open mind, but I do not walk with none aligned. My state of mind is to keep a peaceful peace of mind. I'm like Malcolm with my peace at the Venetian blinds. I'm trying to manifest some things in my subconscious mind that I have only seen in dreams in my unconscious mind. My dreams unrefined, swing the mind, a state of mind that make it seem this lucky life of mine is pre-designed. And if it is, then thank the Lord, cause that's the mastermind.
Listen, yes, Lord. Oh, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Thank you. Send him to the bench, I done lost all respect. I'm gone, I'm on to a D for me. This ain't come from the league, I got money. Take care of mass, ride to the wheels, don't crash. And I hit whoever, long as we get past. Take it back to fail, touchdown. Whoever thought I'd have a buzz down. Still sticking to the script, going deep. Still trying to take care of my people. Football ain't all I know, that was all I chose. Back to the road for me. If I'm put back, don't need how we gon' need that step. I never knew my bros down. Ready to sit here, don't hit too low. No, I need my league. Coach, please sit him, young dog can't catch. Send him to the bench, I done lost all respect. I'm gone down. Ready to sit here, don't hit too low. No, I need my league. Coach, please sit him, young dog can't catch. Send him to the bench, I done lost all respect. I'm gone.
Flow, but we started from the gutter.
Stunned like no one stunner. She curved me back then, came back, so I swung her. I ain't going out like no sucker. Had to let it burn like Usher. Gave a rush for an hour, Chris Tucker. You cannot mistake me for another. I had to wait my time like a buffer. I'm that did I stutter. Ball hard, might get a tick. Bought a push start for it, got a check. Drip too hard, made it. I know she won't forget that we met. She hit her, broke her down, she a wreck. They saying more, you better than the rest. Who, me? I never would've guessed. Ricky, but I do it like a vet.
I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter.
Had to take stairs to the top floor. Every that slept been done for. Got a few bands, need a ton more. If we empty out the that's a drum roll. If we move five, hit him with the 100 strikes. Now that me like a real. Hold on, let me catch my breath. Hold on, let me catch my breath. Getting to the bread, it was crumbs. She loved God, turned nothing into something. She let me knock it out of the park, home run. I'm a giant bear bun. She told me that the money make a. She tried more than the mother. Ain't nothing. I've been always feeling like the one. She says, I'ma show how it's done.
I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never gonna. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor.